Hello friends and welcome back to my channel. As a researcher, have you ever wanted to find a way to ensure that your findings make a positive change in society? I have, and so in this video I'm going to show you my award-winning approach that allowed me to deliver research findings that positively changed behaviours by using 360-degree immersive videos to deliver the research messages. So in this video I'm going to tell you about a project called Research Informed Virtual Relationship-Based Practice Training, or RIVER for short, and how I've used 360-degree immersive videos to introduce research findings to social work practitioners and students. And using the learner's own words, I want to show you some of the impacts that these immersive experiences have had on these trainees. I've had published an in-depth journal paper that goes into a little bit more detail about this project, and at the end of the video, I'll show you how you can access it. To begin with, I'd just like to provide a little bit of background. I was part of an ESRC-funded research team that over 2 years explored how child protection social workers begin, develop and sustain, or not, long-term relationships with children and families. To undertake the research, we used a technique called ethnographic research. And what we did was we followed social workers and observed them at their desks, in their offices, in supervision, in their cars going to and from home visits, and while they were working with families in their homes. And we also observed them while they were attending core groups, child protection conferences, and so on. From these observations, we've produced a number of articles based on this research, and they're available via a link in the comment section below. As a research team, we wanted our findings to have an impact and change practices so that social workers and the families that they worked with had positive long-term outcomes. However, we did have a bit of an issue in that during our research, social workers and managers told us that they found it difficult to find the time to read and digest the findings from academic research papers. Bearing this feedback in mind, we actively started looking for other ways to share our research beyond the traditional journal papers, research conferences, and so on. During discussions, one of the ideas I suggested to the team was, hey, why don't we create immersive 360-degree videos? That way, what we can do is we can recreate the scenes from the research by allowing people to use immersive headsets. By doing this, I argued that what we could do is actually get the learners to feel like as if they were there following us as part of the research team. That way, they could look at and experience those elements that led to good or not so good practice in terms of developing relationships with families and children who are part of the child protection process. So the idea was to allow practitioners on the front line and students, or indeed anybody interested in this field, to feel immersed in the scenes. Also, it was a different way of getting the research messages across, one that basically came off the page and allowed anyone to virtually follow us in the research field. So, over a 2-year period, I worked with Sandwell Children's Trust and we created a 7-module training package based on our original research findings. In this video, what I'd like to do is give you a little bit of a sense of what the trainees felt after they experienced using RIVER. As part of the learning design, I wanted to give the trainees the best seat in the house to observe what it's like to be a child protection social worker carrying out their challenging role and how they can build effective relationships that can lead to positive long-term changes. To do this, our research showed that a range of issues such as professionalism, tone of voice, body language, etc., all played a part in determining whether families experienced good or bad relationships with their social workers. The advantages of using 360-degree headsets was that the trainees and the students felt as though they were there on the visit with the social worker. By using the headsets, this allowed them to feel the emotions of what it's like to be on the visit, get a sense of the impact that body language can have on the role, have the ability to be transported into a setting where they can safely observe things that can impact on the subtle nuances of relationships such as power balances, atmosphere, and tone.
I think being one of the more experienced practitioners, it's been really useful to be part of the relationship-based practice project and the RIVER project in particular. And seeing the outcome of it today as we put on the headsets, I felt really immersed in the whole experience and it felt very, very real.
You're immersed in the experience, so your senses are kind of brought to life as well.
and generates feelings and emotions as though you were on that visit or you were in that situation yourself.
When we was going with the social worker to first visit the family, and John, the father, was standing by the door, you got the sense of how it would feel to be in that sort of environment.
Because of the VR sets, it was quite realistic, and you were able to kind of tilt your head and look at the expressions of all the different people involved in that scene, particularly when there was different like power imbalances based on levels. So you had to, like, in one case you had to like look up, and obviously that kind of symbolised the power imbalance that was kind of there if it was like reality.
I often find reading journal articles quite difficult, and I find myself rereading the article maybe four or five times before it's embedded. I think the benefits of the VR is that I'm there, I can listen to it, I can take my own notes in a format that is accessible to me, and I retain verbal information a lot more quickly and process it differently to how I read information. So for me personally, I would find this extremely accessible.
And it is fun. It's quite immersive. It's new technology that's like new in this century as well. So it has kind of a fun element to it as well.
We also wanted to create an environment in which the trainees and students could learn through observing a child protection social worker in a safe way, but at the same time feel as though they were actually there with them on the visit.
This method of research and how it can influence practice, it's a more immersive experience. I think it enables the trainee to see the options in a protective environment.
Yeah, I would definitely recommend this training to other students, just because you get kind of a first-hand experience of the role of a statutory social worker. You get within the kind of comforts of like a classroom, so you can ask questions, and as a student we haven't been out there, we haven't like seen it firsthand, so it definitely gives you kind of, yeah, that experience to build upon when you do go into practice.
Throughout the course I've wanted to see sort of things that could be said or how situations could be handled, and I feel like using the VR headset you were able to sort of observe a social worker in practice.
We didn't just use the films on their own, but we created a learning design that was carefully crafted so that trainers and educators could just pick up with it and run and deliver their own training. We also used an approach where we replicated the same scene twice to subtly illustrate enablers and barriers to effective practices based on the findings of our research. The enabler and barrier scenes worked quite well, because rather than being a passive learning experience, these scenes triggered discussions amongst the trainees, amongst the training staff, and with more experienced workers.
I felt like I paid attention a little bit more because it wasn't just like a PowerPoint slide. And then we did have social workers come in as well, so we were able to ask questions and build upon the knowledge that we had learned in the river training to kind of like, yeah, advance our knowledge of the situation.
Some of the videos were so similar in the way they came across, but just the tone of voice that the social worker used, or the way they sat, so the way they faced, just those really little things really came across because you felt fully immersed in the videos.
Really good to kind of get an idea about the contrast in practice and how we can be enabling, or we can create barriers. Those barriers might be personal or professional experiences. Yeah, it gives a really good example of how we can visualise the differences and put them into practice.
I liked how when we sort of had the discussions on the table, we were able to compare experiences of practice as well.
So, were we able to get our research messages across? The findings from our evaluations suggested that we were successful, particularly in helping trainees and students understand, through this immersive method, why it's important to build good relationships. We were also successful in helping them understand the steps that they need to take to achieve effective relationship-based practices. These topics are explored in more detail in my journal paper, if you want to read about it further.
I do feel like using VR headsets is a good way of relaying research messages. I feel that the research that had taken place did come across during the videos, and we was able to discuss it after. So some of the examples that we saw on the headsets was then explained in further depth from social workers that were in the room with us.
It's caused me to rethink established patterns and ways of interacting with families and how crucial and fundamental the relationship with our families is compared to anything else.
I think it will give me the confidence more so to support others, to implement relationship-based practice.
So what I've learned from the training about how to deal with hostile relationships and develop good relationships is just communication, planning and prepping. And I've taken away that just building any type of relationship is better than no relationship at all. Even if that seems like particularly small, that's something that you can build upon in the future. And just remaining like open and honest, being kind of transparent with the situation, it means that although people might not be happy with what's happening, as long as they know what's going on, and they don't feel like they're kind of like, you know, out of the situation. So it kind of taught me different ways to deal with like hostility and how actually, if you do continue to develop those relationships, it can actually have a really positive outcome.
I think using this technique, it was a good way to see how a multi-agency approach can be used, how relationships can be built with families, how the use of language can be used. So using a service user's own words, using the child's voice in the process, recognising the strengths of the family as well, I think really came through throughout, especially in the relational videos. So the enabler videos really showed how communication can be utilised, how just making a phone call before a visit can help comfort a family and not just turning up.
So, is immersive video successful in helping us deliver our research findings? Well, our ongoing evaluations suggest that it is. Did it encourage a positive change in behaviours? The feedback from the trainees and our ongoing evaluations certainly suggests that learners are more aware of those elements, such as arriving on time, monitoring their tone of voice, observing their environment, being consistent and respectful, and expecting effective relationship-based supervision are all factors that can help them improve the relationship-based practice with children and families. You can see that using 360-degree video can positively impact learners' experiences and change their practices. I explore these elements in much more detail in my paper that you can freely access using the link below. If you have any observations or questions about this approach, please do leave a comment below and I will do my best to answer. I've created some more videos about teaching and learning design that you might find interesting here. Please do like, share and subscribe for more videos. I really hope you found this video useful and I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye.